My father was doing all kinds of repair for different cars, big trucks. When I was little, I always followed him all the way. And when I was about 16, 17, I began to work on a car mechanica. I always liked big trucks and all things. And my father was doing some rescuing on small cars, and I was always with him, and I have taken it with me all the way, so maybe it was a call that this is what I'm going to do the rest of my life. Every time, almost, it's different accidents, different trouble with the cars, always new thing that happened that makes your brain working a little harder to try to fix it for the different people, different cars. No, it's not the same every day. It's always different. Well, I think the first thing is that you have to like helping people, like working with cars, like driving. Don't always see what the time is and now I have worked seven, now I can't work more than 7 hours. You have to work when it's work to do. It's not a 9-to-5 work. You have to 24-hour. You must like what you're doing, different works on cars, small car, big cars, winter, cold, summer, hot. You must like it. And if you like it, I think it would be very, very good work for the right person. Even if it's girl or man, it's the same. Well, before it wasn't so much women doing this rescue and the car place, but now, today, I think it's getting better because it's going to be... I've seen that it's been very much women doing the same work as we. If you go back for 10, 15 years, you can almost repair very much of the car, but nowadays it's too much electrical. You can't do anything at the road. You have to put it on your truck and go to the nearest garage because you have to have special equipment to repair it. Back in old days, you can almost repair everything, but not today. In the future, I think you can't be a car mechanic. You have to be a car electrician. I have to learn a lot, but it's too much, so I don't have time to follow it. So. Everyone needs update and it takes time, so too much electrical and you have to have the special equipment, too expensive. That's why you have to go to bigger city, bigger town that have the right equipment, the right people for the work. Well, when I get a call, it depends on what it is, of course, but if I get a call, when I'm going from my place to the other place that the customer is waiting, I try to have it in my head what to do when I come to the place and have a look. Yeah, if I get a good description of the accident, when I drive, I use very much time to see different angle, different thing to do when I come to the place, then I realize this I can do, this I can't do. When you come to the place, you see, oh, I can't do anything, I have to think new. But that's not easy, because I'm working here alone. I'm not always home when they are home. Maybe it's very often I go out when they are coming home at 4 o'clock. I go out and I come back sometimes 8 in the morning. Then they are going at work. So the dinner is very often cold, so I made it myself. My wife is doing... school things. My girl is finished school. I hope she will go to maybe a car mechanicer to try, see if it's something for her. Maybe she can take over my place to work with cars and trucks. Well, it's a lot of memories because I was only 18 years old. It was a school bus up in Morbidalen that went very bad because it's too much people dying. And I was young, luckily too young to understand the serious of it. And a different big crash yet that the driver died, and that's sort of thing that you think of, but you can't think too much, but then you can't do anything. The school bus was my first, and then it has been a lot of accidents after. It was tough, but that's when you see if you want to do this, you do it. If you're not, you find another job. Well, you can't think that way. It's a job. You do the work, and you don't think. You think after you finish the work. Well, it's a lot of accidents that I've learned a lot of, and the most fine with the thing is that when you come to the accident and you fix the car back on the road so the driver can start it and go further with the same car, then you find out that this was a good job. Well, it's always a challenge, and when you come to an accident or anything that you see that I'm alone and I only have one truck, then you begin thinking, the road is closed, I can't do it on my own, where do I get help? Then I have to go to the phone and call Tore Nodda to get him to the place. But the challenge is that it's taking maybe 2 hours before he can be here, and the road is closed and it's a lot of people waiting. That's the biggest challenge, what to do to open the road. Well, back in when I was starting, it was a good old thing. You have a clutch and you have a big gear stang that you use the gear that you want to do. Today it's electrical, automatic, so you just have to put it in gear and give gas. Technology is going too fast. The first, back in old days, you have this big mobile telephone that you used. Today you have a small phone, smartphone and all thing, but that's not for me because I'm too old to use that stupid thing. The people are going to see the different trucks. Different people have different cars, snowy, windy. Well, I don't think it has changed me, but the only thing that it's a lot of people coming in and want to have photo, and they see me everywhere, where I am and where I'm going, they are seeing, oh, you are the famous guy, oh yes. But I'm the same man, very easy.